GenePattern provides four modules for the handling of Illumina expression data. For this tutorial, we will focus on how to convert Illumina gene expression files into the GenePattern GCT expression file format for use in GenePattern workflows using the Illumina Expression File Creator module. At the end, we will also review the capabilities of the Illumina DASLL pipeline. Illumina Expression File Creator converts raw Illumina bead array data to the GenePattern GCT file format. For information regarding reference data created with Illumina Bead Studio and Genome Studio, please see the module documentation. The module extracts the mean value for each probe from a set of Illumina Expression IDAT files, supplied in a single zip archive. Note that all IDAT files must be of the same array type. An array annotation file, which corresponds to the Illumina IDAT files provided as input, is required. You may either provide your own here, or select your manifest from the drop-down list. If you choose to provide a manifest, be sure it is in the tab-delimited text format and not the binary BGX format. For this tutorial, we will choose a manifest from the list. We can choose to name our output file or let the module automatically name the result file to match the input file. We will choose the latter. The module can optionally perform background subtraction. The background value is calculated as the mean of the negative control signal values. This number is subtracted from all gene probe values, but not from the control probe values. We will leave this set to false for this tutorial. Collapse mode allows us to choose whether to collapse probes into a single value or not. If we were to collapse the probes, we could choose between collapsing to the mean or max values. In this tutorial, we will leave the selection at none. We may optionally provide a chip file of our own or from the drop-down list, which would allow probes to be mapped to gene names for collapsing or to look up descriptions. We will not provide a chip file in this tutorial, so the module will use the mapping provided in the manifest. By default, sample names are derived from the IDAT file names in the input zip archive. In order to annotate the samples, we could provide a CLM file. This would allow us to specify a set of IDAT files and sample names to be used in the creation of the GCT file. For this tutorial, we will not use a CLM file. Now that the parameters are configured, we can run the module. The module outputs two GCT files. The first contains the values for the gene probes. The second contains the values for the control probes. If we'd specified a CLM file, a CLS file would also be present here with the result files. The resulting GCT files can now be used as input to any GenePattern module that accepts this file type. We'll now briefly review the IlluminaDASLL pipeline. The IlluminaDASLL pipeline can be used to create a GenePattern GCT file from the raw scan output of an Illumina bead array reader. Currently, the pipeline supports the 6K transcriptionally informative gene or TIG panel. The pipeline is comprised of three modules, the Illumina Scan Extractor, the Illumina Normalizer, and the Illumina Concatenator. The modules may be run on their own, but all three are needed in sequence to create the GCT file and properly pre-process the data. Therefore, we encourage you to use the Illumina DASLL pipeline. The input file is a text file that lists the scans to be extracted from the Broad-hosted archive. You may also configure an outlier method, normalization method, whether to discard controls, and whether you want a GCT file containing the concatenated data values or a GCT file containing the concatenated detection scores. The resulting GCT file can be used as input to any GenePattern module which accepts GCT files as input. More information about the pipeline and its modules can be found in the pipeline documentation. For further information about GenePattern, please visit genepattern.org.